Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech DIY. So today we are going to see Spring Boot OpenAPI integration, and with this example we are going to use OpenAPI code generator plugin, Maven plugin, and with that we will generate the whole API itself out of our specification. These are the key moments: introduction, API specification, issues we face during making this code, and the resolutions of those issues, and finally final testing. So you can jump to any section of your interest at any point of time, and the links would be available in the description section. And yes, for following this video, we have code example, we have used Swagger editor. Here you can see the language, the YAML example, with which we can follow and we can generate our API endpoints and the whole objects, and we can define our objects and everything in the YAML format. So we are also going to do something like this, and we are going to write one specification file and pom.xml, mainly pom.xml and specification file, and then we will build our project. And once the build is successful, we should be able to get the generated Spring API code into our target folder. Okay, so that's what we are going to see today. As you can see here in the Swagger editor left pane, it is showing like order object, and it has shown the paths also. So paths are basically the endpoints. Path tag will be used for defining the endpoints, and their responses and their requests, response success and failure responses also we can define them. And once we follow across, we will see each and every part when we will define our own specification file. So with that, we are just showing all the details. Just like here we are having user object. So let's get started. We have opened our very own launchpad, that's start.spring.io, and we are naming, we are going to have simple dependencies, like we are going to have just Spring Web, and as always we are going to use Lombok. We will see if Lombok we can make use of, and that's what we have done. We have downloaded the code, and now we are simply importing the project there in IntelliJ IDEA. And once it is, as you can see, the project is imported now in the IntelliJ. And meanwhile, this is the site I was talking about. It's reflectoring.io, and in under this, I came across this very nice article, and it's very good. You should follow this article. It tells about how we can generate the API code from the Swagger specification which we are going to have. So as you can see, these are the dependencies. And don't worry guys, this time onwards I will add the pom.xml and the specification file into one internet location, and I'll share that location also with you guys, so you can refer that. Okay, and here we are going to write the YAML file. We are going to name it as Spring OpenAPI example.yaml, and this whole is going to have the whole API as we have just now seen under swagger.io, Swagger editor. So the same language we are going to write here in our YAML file. Okay, so we are going to have the version as shown in the referred link. And So mainly for this we need to add the swagger related annotation, swagger annotation, swagger UI, and open API tools also we need to add. So all those things we have added here, and the plugin which I was telling about is this one, open API generator Maven plugin. So this plugin here we need to define about this plugin, as you can see in the left side pen, and here these are the version I'm writing under the properties file. So it's one of the best practice, we should always have the version under properties tag, just as it shows about the Java version. So similar way our dependency versions we would be defining there in the properties, and we would be referring those version here in the at the place wherever it is needed. Okay, so goal we need to define as generate, artifact and all we have given already, and then in under execution tag we need to define goals, we need to define input spec, that is project based directory and source, I mean the location of this YAML file basically, so that's what we have given here, and after that we need to give the generator name. So generator name is, we are simply saying Spring, so it will generate for Spring. Then we need to have the API package, so API package which we are having here for our example, we have taken that and we have pasted that, and for model package the same package we are going to use, path we are going to use, and followed by dot model, so all our model classes would go under this model package. Okay, and then further we will be defining the config options, and for config options delegate pattern we are enabling, so the magic of that I will show you once the whole API would be done, so that time I will show you. Basically delegate pattern says like whatever task, if we are doing multiple tasks, so we should delegate some of our tasks to some other classes, okay, instead of doing everything by our own, we should divide that and we should delegate that. And yeah, this is also one article which I found in building.com, so you can refer that also, and it's always better to refer multiple articles while trying these kind of examples. Okay, so yeah, that's it, and here we are defining the dependencies which will be needed here. We are going to have, as I said earlier, we are going to have open API generator dependency we have added, then we have added JSON data bind nullable, this is again another dependency. These are the dependencies we will be needed, we will be requiring in this particular session, and we are trying to, you know, we are just to show you guys one by one I am adding the dependencies and, you know, refreshing the Maven project, so that you will realize, okay, this is how we should actually do in real scenario, then only we will come to know, okay, what dependencies will help for which particular functionality. Okay, so it will show that the errors in the console, and then, you know, that's how I have added that there. And now here we are defining our specification.yaml, that's the name is Spring Open API example.yaml, and as you can see here we have given the title, we have given the description, then email, simply we have given tech DIY channels email ID, so, and then external docs, I mean we are focusing on minimalistic approach here, so we will be defining, these are the info part, and after that we will define the tags, and then we will define the so here also we are going to create another blog, so we are going to have a blog use case wherein we should be able to, you know, we are going to define one endpoint, and with that endpoint we should be able to get the blog. So for the sake of time, I'm only doing the get part, but yeah, you can refer this whole tutorial, and it has shown all the CRUD operations there. So you can define all the endpoints here. So now, as I was telling, so here I'm defining the path. So under paths tag, we are going to say like, okay, we are going to have blog slash blog name or blog title, and then tags we are going to have under that paths are dash blog summary. Simply we have given some summary, some sort of detail about the blog, about this particular path we are going to give. And yeah, it was HTTP get, as you may see in the line number 18. Line number 16, it says like get. So this is going to be the get path. And if we are going to have multiple, you know, if we are going to have the same URL for multiple, you know, request types, like it can have the post, it can have the put. So that also we can, you know, do by adding multiple values here. Like here we have added the get tag, and we can have the post, put, if we want to have the same URL and you know, different based on request it works, then we can define like that also. So now we are going to have the components. Under components, we are going to define the blog object. So here we are actually under schemas, we are saying schema object schema. So when we say object schema, what it means is like we are defining the resource. So the resource is a blog. So what type of resource it is? It is an object, and it would be having three properties, and ID, title, and content. So that we have defined there, and now we are simply building the API. So this is the first time build, and as expected, it failed. So now let's see. And since it's a YAML file, so while writing the YAML file by hand, there may be errors, lots and lots of errors you may face, and that's what I faced here also. It seems, yeah. Yeah, so it says OpenAPI. Fail to read resource listing. Line number 9, column number 15, description. Okay. I think the main problem, or we can say like, although YAML file significantly reduces our work, or we can say like we can define the root tag and all the tags we can define here properly in a structured way, but still since it follows the indentation logic same as Python and the new languages, so if we do any kind of mistakes while defining the indentation, then these kind of errors will start coming. And believe me, they are also it shows properly, like as in this case it is showing the proper errors. So we can go one by one and we can, you know, resolve those things. And one good thing I will tell you about IntelliJ or any editor, there is something called column editing mode. So we can make use of column editing mode in such scenarios wherein we want to, you know, edit the things in column way, in the columnar way. So I have switched that to the my editor to column mode, and I can, you know, in these many lines I can simultaneously edit. So I have done that, and I have corrected the indentation for those tags from line number 18 till line number before component tag. So yeah, but let's but still we are getting this, so let's see again. Okay, so we need to correct that as well. Slash dash name colon blog. So this is in line number 10, column number 4, external docs. So these all are indentation issues. So this is the only only thing we need to extremely take care of while writing the YAML file, so as we will get less indentation errors, and we can easily finish off our code. So yeah, I have corrected that and now I'm rerunning it. Okay, line number 18, column number 10. So that also we need to define column number 18, line number column number 18. Yeah, summary, get the blog by title. Okay, I think here also the indentation should be corrected. Yeah, so all the, yeah, I mean it should align with the tags. It is not under tags, it is in parallel with tag or sibling of tags. Summary, okay. Here as we can see in the file or in the site in the left side. Okay, so again in column mode we are going to change the indentations as needed, and here you can see like responses, what are the responses we are going to have. And ref hash, you can see like ref also. So that ref is basically, instead of writing the whole object there itself in the response body, we can write like that and we can refer in the section. Like there it was under component slash component name. Okay, like that it was. So that is what. Okay, the issue which I was facing was related to blog name. While doing the hand coding, I, instead of writing the blog title, I have written blog name, and we are going to search based on blog title. Okay, so yeah, that is what we have done. And one more thing we have forgot to add is version. We need to add the version of our specification API, so then only it will generate. So now we have corrected all those things, and okay, EP, it seems like it has generated some code, at least some code in the first hand. So yeah, but some code, but still there are some issues. So now we will see what issues we are having here. Okay, so it seems we need to add some more dependencies. Spring Fox Swagger UI. So again, this version also we will define under the properties, and I'll do that. Let me add first. So Swagger annotations we need to have, and Swagger UI. I have added Spring Fox Swagger UI. Added Spring annotations. And yeah, as I mentioned earlier, so this Swagger annotation version would be defining, we are going to define. So what dependencies we have added here? Mainly OpenAPI tool first, then Swagger, Swagger annotations, then Spring Fox Swagger UI, and the other one is Spring Fox Swagger 2. Okay, so these are the dependencies we will need here. And yeah, here we are going to define all the versions, version keys. First is for Swagger annotation version, then we are going to define for Spring Fox, and then we are also going to define for any other leftover things. So yeah, so ideally after that I have simply run the Maven refresh. I have done the Maven refresh, so it has downloaded the dependencies into my local M2, and here it seems this time it should generate properly. Yeah, it seems it has generated, and now the spring, okay, again it failed. Let's see where it has actually failed. So under, so as you can see, the target folder, under target we are going to have all these generated code. So this is what I was talking about, and it seems there is some issue with annotations, with annotations, Swagger annotations. So I tried this particular, I struggled with this issue here lot, and I spent a lot of time here, but you guys won't believe, but it happens when you are continuously doing something. You should give yourself a break and you should try it again. So I left it at this place, and then I restarted, I rebooted my system, and magically when I restarted my IDE, these things got resolved. I mean, how it happens is, whenever we restart the IDE, and it indexes the complete project again, and it tries to see for the dependencies, whatever dependencies we are having already defined under our project, under our pom.xml or Gradle, and it will use them. It will use them and make them available if the indexing, if there was some issue. So while system refresh, it always try to try to link those things properly. So that's why, although it is ridiculous to say, like, whenever something doesn't work, we should boot or just stop it and restart. But the logic behind that is this. Okay, so now, as you can see, now in my POM everything is fine. I have defined everything properly. This POM file will be available on the link in the description section. So you can go there and you can you make use of that POM file, and you can refer the specification file also. That also I have pasted. So yeah, those things will be available there. And I have also provided the main file which we can refer for writing our where we will be writing our business logic. So that part, that file also I am going to provide there. I mean, that's the starting point for us now. So yeah, after this, finally build is success, yippee. And now we are going to see the source code under target. So this is what is generated. It looks it looks beautiful, and with all the annotations and everything is already done for us. So we just need to go there, we need to explore it, and so that's what we are doing here. So blog is generated, blog API is generated, and API util is also one class which is generated. And we are, as I told earlier, we are going to use the blog API controller here. The blog API controller also generated, blog is generated, blog API is generated, then blog delegate. So what is happening here is, controller is getting, get mapping is there with the controller, and controller is passing it over to the get delegate method, and finally the get delegate API would be actually doing that. So if everything is fine and our service is started properly, our API is started properly, we have tried to hit the URL, that is 8081/blog/blog title, and what we have found is 501. So if everything has been properly done, we should get the error 501 initially, because we have not defined anything here. Okay, now at this point of time, post this point of time, we are going to actually define the logic. So here what we are going to do is, we are simply, for this example, we are simply, when we say blog slash blog title, we are going to simply provide the one hard-coded data. So that's what we are going to do. And instead, in real life scenarios, you would define your classes which will implement the delegate interface, and will define the getDelegate method. So we don't need to worry about the API. So API is completely generated, and we just need to define the delegate, and delegate will take care of, you know, business logic. So it's a kind of, you know, it's a kind of magic. So yeah, we are going to be, so as you can see, we have defined one delegate IMPL class. So we are in our case, it's a blog API delegate IMPL. So this is going to, the parent for this is obviously blog API. So under blog API delegate, blog API delegate interface, we are having the get delegate method, which we are going to override here. As you can see, this at service we need to mark, because this is our main place where we are going to code our business logic, or we can say like starting point for us. Okay, so all the CRUD operations related to blog delegate IMPL will be defined here. Like get blog by title is one method defined under the blog API delegate interface. And yeah, so as you can see, that particular thing we are going to override, that method we are going to override here. Yeah, here comes one other message. The blog title we are going to have is target 100k subs, so we are targeting for that. And content we are going to say, again repeat myself, like, share, subscribe our work. If you really like our work, share it with your friends, with your colleagues, subscribe to our channel. So we will it inspires us to, you know, try our hands with different things under the sun under the sun of Spring, Java, that space. So yeah, so basically that's what we have done here. So now this method returns response entity OK, and we are going to return this blog object which we have just now created. And if everything is fine, this time when we hit 8081 slash blog slash blog title, that is actually target 100k subs. So when we hit that, it will show us a JSON object. So we are rebooting the server, and let's see if everything is fine. We should be able to get a JSON object. Yeah, so that is what we are going to do here. We are going to hit that. We are simply building it, and it is running. It was somewhat slow, so at the time of recording this, it was building again completely, and it will give us the, it will prompt us with 8081 port, and our Tomcat would be running on that, and the server would be listening on that port. Yeah, and it's starting. Things are fine. NAP, the server is started after all the errors and all the hard work which we have put here. Now the server is started. And so target 100k subs, we are going to copy it, and we are going to give that under, instead of blog title. So this is what I was telling about. So now we are having a plugin here on the Chrome, so that shows pretty plugin. So it shows the JSON in this format, and yeah, finally it has been shown like this. Target 100k subs. Thanks for watching, guys, and please like, share and subscribe to us, so that will inspire us to make more videos on such topics. And until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, enjoy life and keep learning. Bye.